Hi, I'm Dolores Friesen, and I have just completed 1,000 workouts. Wow, I can hardly believe it. I'm 62 years old, and I'm a retired nurse working casual, also a wife, a mother, and a grandmother. I started at what was Fit Body Bootcamp just over 3 years ago, and although I took a few short breaks, I've been a regular at Fit Club North ever since. This is the longest time I have committed myself to one fitness place in my lifetime. I love this place. I could not imagine myself being anywhere else right now. Even with these current restrictions keeping us off the blue and having to do virtual workouts at home, I have completed the last 300 or so workouts during these restrictions. What has been the biggest change for me from 100 to 1,000 workouts? Well, there have been multiple changes. And for me, it's been a gradual weight loss of more than 25 pounds, and this time, keeping it off. I have a whole new wardrobe now, and even more importantly, a gradual increase in strength and fitness. I've been able to increase my muscle mass, lower my body fat, and increase my ability to tolerate exercise longer and at a more intense rate. I think my first goal was to be able to complete more than one workout in a day, and later I had a goal to complete a push-up from my toes, gradual heavier weights to keep it challenging, trying to get that 1% better every day. I'm not gonna lie, there was not a pain-free workout, and everyone was sweaty to various degrees. That was 1,000 painful, sweaty workouts. Was it worth it? Heck yes. And my attitude has changed to one of being more content with myself in this level of fitness. I'm just feeling great. Here I stand, the living proof that it's possible to get in the best shape of my life and feel this good at my age and after retirement even. Now my goal is straightforward. I just maintain what I have and I never look back. This means I cannot go back to the old ways of eating or old ways of slacking, and I have to continually cement these new ways into my entire lifestyle. Some of the struggles that I've had were the injuries I had to overcome. At first I had a lot of trouble with my neck and shoulders, not anymore. And then it was my back, that's not anymore. Then plantar fasciitis, that's gone now. And hip pain that I'm still dealing with. But these are musculoskeletal problems that can be overcome by continually working on my posture, mobility stretching, muscle strengthening, even modifications for some of high impact movements, but never by stopping. Stopping's never the answer. During times away from Fit Club, during travel or at the lake, away from the internet content, it can be quite difficult since I'm very lonely working out by myself. And I really thrive on the energy of the live workouts. I cannot wait to be back on the blue with all of you. So I would like to thank the coaches at Fit Club for the amazing and creative workouts and the programs they've provided. Despite the current obstacles, keeping up the positive vibe and encouraging all of us to get our goals, celebrating our milestones, calling us out by name, that means a lot to be recognized and to be known. Coach RJ, what you've been building is bar none. You're continually adapting to the times. Others can only try to keep up with you. And such a force of change to so many, I am grateful to be part of this Fit Fam that you've created. Coach Jen, you are amazing. You've become an incredible coach and encourager. I just love your classes. Coach Rick, your class was the first one I attended regularly, and I sure miss those solid workouts that you led. Just looking forward to getting back on the blue with everyone as soon as possible. And the challenges that I've been able to participate in have been so important to me to learn about nutrition and lifestyle changes, which are necessary to achieving and maintaining these results. And I have grown through every one. And of course, I want to thank the many friends at Fit Club that encouraged me and worked out with me these last 3 years. I'm a fairly reserved person and it takes me time to make new friends, but here I've been able to fit in. I feel part of it and I've been able to thrive on the energy and I love the fun that we can have together. What would I say to my past self is, don't be so hard on yourself. Instead of expecting perfection and setting up for failure or sabotaging myself, don't wait so long to figure this out. Try to look around and find others who share realistic goals and who are not there to compete, rather to encourage you and others to be the best that we can, and then be realistic about it. This is for life. I would like to encourage any of you pursuing 1,000 workouts to just keep pushing. You'll get there before you know it. And also be kind to yourself. Take care of yourself. Be realistic. It's not a race, it's a marathon. And it's got ups and downs. With this journey, there may be a few setbacks, but don't give up. And don't set yourself up to fail. Don't sabotage yourself. Just keep going. You're fine. Keep going. And you will make it. But of course, 1,000 workouts isn't the end. It's part of the journey. A milestone, an achievement, a place marker. To celebrate what's been accomplished and a call to press on. It's okay to be proud of this achievement. I'm Dolores Friesen, and this is my 1,000th workout. And I am looking forward to seeing you all on the blue.